You know the routine. Wait for the beep.
Gentlemen, last time I was on tour, we were talking private jets, limos with car phones. Now here I am getting off this crowded bus to use a payphone in front of some Chinese carryout restaurant something or other. But listen, I'm not complaining, and I dare any of you guys to come out here and hang with us.
Thomas Shaw is
the great cousin.
Always like him.
I like the music, I like Thomas Shaw, and I like them all.
To stay insane. See Thomas Shaw.
Thomas Shaw!
I used to change his diapers when he was little.
Yeah, with an eye.
Well, I like that leather stuff.
My hair? Yeah, we can go to the
bathroom. Off
we go.
Hurry up.
Thank you.
gentlemen, we need a new bus. One where the microwave works, okay?
The bus.
The bus.
The bus.
The bus.
I love the bus. And it's very easy. I mean, it's very comfortable. You're probably very envious of the fact that we do get to sleep in these things.
The bus is not nearly the bad place we thought it would be.
I can see how nice this is. This is the queen size bed.
I've enjoyed the bus.
Now you realize when I put my this guy can't sleep. That's his problem because I'm going to bed first.
It's never fun to be on a bus for 12 or 14 hours, but once every couple of weeks, it's passable.
This is real nice. Let me just get these mushrooms out of here.
I found out the back is not the place to be. It's like sitting in the tail of the plane, you know.
Occupational hazard here. You can't sleep with your head that way. Because if the bus stops short, and I mean like something serious, like just a stop sign, it'll break your neck.
Sometimes if I'm real tired, I'll bitch and moan about it and threaten to call the whole thing off. But then we get up on stage and start playing. God, this is great.
What you got is your head got to be this way. So in case you stop short, you only break an ankle. And me being a saxophone player, it doesn't make a difference. Now our drummer, he goes for the broken neck. Okay? Because if he breaks an ankle, he can't play the drums.
What's it feel like after you've done the 14-hour drive?
14 hours? The bus, home away from home.
I'm gonna sell my house. But I'm gonna get me a bus just like that. Oh, I love the bus.
We're gonna start with the stops.
In that case, we're gonna send this next one out to all of you who ever felt like you had too much time on your hands.
It's just something that everybody should hear, you know, because, and it's just so great. His music to us is great, I guess because he's our son.
My mother, before each new record comes out, she swears she's heard it on the radio. And I always feel like asking her mother, they didn't happen to mention it, how it was doing in the charts, did they?
The whole town of Montgomery, city of Montgomery, is behind Tommy. And he's very popular here. Even if he wasn't my son, I'd brag on him, I guess.
My father likes to, he's sort of an independent record guy for me. He goes around all the record stores and makes sure they have the record, and if it's not in a predominantly placed position, he will put it there himself.
We got it up front on the wall.
Is that all you got?
Mm-hmm. I got them all displayed on the front wall up here.
Been selling out.
Mm-hmm.
That's fine.
Sure have. So we had to make a decision to either join him or kick him out of the house.
So we
took a vote and we joined him then, and we never have had so much fun.
As long as my father doesn't start bringing women into the dressing room, that's yes. My only problem. I think there's something that's undeniably part of rock and roll anymore. And like them or not, they're here to stay. I like them a lot. there's something that I think each artist really has to develop his own ideas and his own image about. And I had the baptism of fire, and that personally, you know, when it came time to do my Girls with Guns video, it's hard to break old habits, you know, and I immediately went and did this big production video. I got it back and I looked at it. It's beautiful, but it's just wrong. So it's something you really have to stay on top of, because you can wind up, you know, going through a lot of trouble and have something represent you that you don't want. And I was fortunate enough to have good friends at the record company who were behind me and said, you know, we'll just forget this ever happened. Yeah, I don't know if you've seen the one that we have out now.
I saw the one that's out now. It's the black and white one that takes place in the studio.
And that's what I want. That's the way I felt. It was just rock and roll. Just set up the gear and let us play. Feel about trying to do Renegade tonight?
The musicians that I'm playing with now are stylistically they're quite a bit different from the members of Styx, and these guys most of them have done a lot of work in the studio where they're used to working with the tempos being right there, and if they don't get those tempos perfect, then they probably don't get hired back. In some ways sound more like they do on the record than when I did them with Styx.
So far from my home. Somebody take this part.
Oh, mama, I can hear you crying. You're so scared and all alone. Hangman is coming down from.
Brian Stanley, I think, could more properly be called Animal, believe it or not. He seems like such a gentle person, and he is in person, nice, even-tempered. But on stage, the guy really just completely turns into like an animal. He's just bass players. To me, it's hard for a bass player to really be mobile on stage, and he, for some reason, gets by and is just a real treat to play with on stage. Timekeeper extraordinaire. He has whipped this band into keeping good time. Steve is the one who's real good at when things just look like I'm ready to throw in the towel. But Steve's got, he's got the great attitude about like that. When the chips are down, just go forward. Richie Cannata is, it's like this new instrument for me on stage. I've always worked with guitar players, and guitar is the sort of thing that it's, I always thought it was one of a kind because it's an expressive sort of thing.
Oh, no, I'm ready.
And, you know.
This is Tommy Shaw. How you doing? I saw your show there. Yeah? I saw Styx. I haven't seen you. I mean, it's a pleasure meeting you.
Come see us tonight.
What is this for? What is this camera for?
This is for MTV.
Well, that's kind of interrupting, but how is it? How do you feel going from being like a headliner on Styx to warming up? How are you handling it?
Handling it real well. We're working hard and being a little cranky about it once in a while, but we're turning out with a good band.
Is it totally different members?
Completely different, yeah.
And it's working out real well?
Yeah, it is. You should come see it tonight. This is the next to the last show.
Really, that you're doing? Is it going to be all original material, or you have some Styx in there? Or?
Three Styx songs. The rest
Crystal
of it's
Ball?
All new. No, Crystal Ball yet.
Rico. All right, listen.
Can you get these guys' names?
It's really
They're
nice
gonna come to
the
show. Yeah.
Take
it easy.
That was great.
That guy was great. I wish people who get paid to interview me asked questions like that.
Pouring and
come out of the dark? Would you hold our thoughts in silence? Would you free them with a shout? Would you demonstrate your patience while your destiny's dealt out?
On, some friends got together to make some music, and what a homecoming it was for the rock musician who grew up in Montgomery. Tonight, in a Southside feature, Tom Foreman talks about Tommy's future and his past.
Once upon a time, Tommy Shaw found a crystal ball. It told him he'd be famous. What it didn't tell him was just how famous. The Montgomery native may well be on the brink of becoming not a rock and roll star, he's already that. How about a rock and roll legend?
This was that the dance band that I was in.
Of course, like most success, it has not come easily. Shaw started playing guitar at the age of 9 and spent years playing local nightclubs before his big break came. That was in 1975 when he joined a group called Styx.
You know, if you're at the corner of opportunity and chance, if you stay there long enough, you know, something's liable to come by. But if you're...
It was with Styx that Shaw started not just making records, but making millions of records.
I really never thought about it. I was just having a good time doing what I was doing, playing my music and hanging out with the guys in the band. And darn if I'm still not doing the same thing. You know?
He's still doing it all right. Now with a new band and a new solo album. There is the chance Shaw will at least once in a while get back in touch with his former group, Styx. But for now, Tommy Shaw is more interested in making it on his own and looking into his crystal ball one more time.
We leave you tonight with a TV 12 Friday night video of sorts with rock star Tommy Shaw. Have a nice one.
Men, if I don't get a decent meal in my stomach soon, this tour is toast.
Here's the suffering on the road.
Yeah. The suffering on the road.
We do this every day. On the bus. Even on the bus we do this. We do this in the dressing room. And pretty soon we'll be doing this on stage. Honest. It's a real drag being on the road. And Tommy subjects us to this every other day. He makes us come into these places like this and sit here.
On the Paradise Theater tour, $13,000 worth of room service and two trips.
Spoiled. I mean, they're riding on cabs every day. And, you know, they're used to riding in limos. So I have to make them come in here and do this every once in a while, just to show them the cabs are better than limos. It's a drag. Simple drag. But that's life on the road.
You know, I think I was built for the road. You know, I don't mind living out of a suitcase, and I still like to eat, you know, cruddy food. You like the liver-flavored or the asparagus-flavored?
Oh, man.
You just drank one sake?
We do have a rule against eating in the studio here.
Well, if you can call this food, I suppose.
We ordered meatballs. We ordered a cheese tray that you could have put it in a UN meeting, and it would have been too much. We didn't eat one piece of cheese. We threw the cheese.
I said, can I smoke one of your cigarettes? I know you smoke. You do smoke, don't you? Jeff?
Hey, everybody. Ice water on me, huh?
Oh, man.
Okay.
We had bathtubs full of the most expensive champagne money can buy. bathtubs full of it, 600 pounds of ice, and we still ran out of liquor.
Yes, could you send up a large pot of coffee?
It's always breakfast time here.
It's lunchtime.
When you work these long hours like this, this is breakfast time.
Excuse me.
I know what I want, I just don't see it. The perfect combination.
Everything's gonna be okay.
I suppose you have to get pancakes here, don't you, in one way or another?
Usually, you know, the salad platter at the sound check is pretty good.
Chocolate chip pancakes, what a nourishing breakfast.
Truly special breakfast.
Oh, God, you're not gonna get fat, are you?
Thank you.
There you go. Okay. Sign these for me, please.
Yours through cream and coffee. Thank you very much.
Who's it from?
It's from Johnny Shaw.
I'd like you to say hello to the folks out there in MTV land.
Tommy Shaw!
Hey, how y'all doing out there? My name is Earl Dean Sibley. Glad to meet you all.
We used to fly in a plane that would have embarrassed an Arab.
This has nothing to do with anyone except for me. This is pizza for me. I get a big one, spread it around a little bit. It's good for morale. The People's Pizza. And could I get a receipt, please?
Did you get Story on the Road food yet?
Dog food.
How's the pizza?
Great.
Oh, tell me, it's excellent. I made it.
Pizza's a little spotty.
Pizza and vitamin C, yeah.
Well, the roadies earn it for the money and the women.
Uh-huh.
We're in it for the food.
I think you better come along with me. This looks like a case of eating a pizza without a license.
Pizza Central.
Deep pan pizzas, video to color TVs, bedrooms. It was a chic. We lived like chics out there.
Food Mart sounds good.
We get this like twice a week.
Let's do Burger King.
And we get oatmeal three times a week.
It's road food, I tell you.
Spam on Sunday.
When Burger King and all this stuff starts looking good.
And we're the happiest people on earth. It's true.
It is consistent. Nothing like a little health food for you out here.
I mean, I have a problem with one thing.
It's not standing in the sunset.
Why is there a hamburger in? Now we're living like animals.
We asked to have something there to drink, you know, a little something here and there. And there were two lemons and about a half-eaten jar of mixed nuts.
When they had a tray of chocolate eclairs stuffed with custard, like big, these kind.
There was a gallon jug of milk that had that much milk left in the bottom of it, and a jar of orange juice that somebody had already opened up and drank out of.
You know these kind of eclairs? Kind of like that.
When you're the headline act, then you can start complaining in the trash in the dressing room.
No, bigger. Big.
There was nothing there to trash with. How many times can you throw a couple of lemons against the wall?
One of those.
And one nice thing about being an opening act,
these are great bananas. These are some of the finest bananas in the world.
Yeah. There were 50 of them.
Hi, can I have a Big Mac and an order of fries? No, I don't really want any. It's canceled.
Mmm, road food. It's great.
All right, here we go!
guys, one good thing about these club dates, it's so much easier to pick out a good-looking woman out of an audience of 800 than it is out of 18,000 seats, let me tell you.
The all-new All-Hit 106 KMEL and Hall & Oates Out of Touch and Howard Hoffman at 3:15, along with my special guest Tommy Shaw, formerly of Styx, now out on his own, doing himself a real good, nice solo career. How is everything going?
We're having fun.
Yeah, just rocking out.
We're going to go play next door.
You have this intimacy there, and you can't really go into a stage and pretend that you're at the Forum. You got to go in there and play it like it is.
It's so intense in you. You think you hate it, but when it's all over with, it's like, that was, I feel better now, and I'm in a lot better shape because of that.
Right after this, we're going to be going out with the Kinks, and we're going to be playing in the Big Barns again. I tell you what, this is so much fun, I can't explain it.
Broke down in Little Go World.
No.
That was beautiful. It was like, she was just sobbing away. It was incredible.
Yeah. That sounded real nice tonight.
Yeah, it did.
This is so much fun, man. Yes. Those kids really.
It's too much fun, I can't take it! I want to have a bad time! I want to come out and scream at people!
There has to be a better way of life.
Learn to operate under, you know, real minimal conditions and really overcome all the problems that we're going to find to be much smaller in the big halls.
And I knew that he was just, he was good enough that he should be in a larger place, you know, than a smoky nightclub.
Tonight was one of those where we had the real tiny stage, we had problems, but it was, we were so hot, you know, our attitude was just right. We're just tired enough so that there's no tension up there, you know.
I would sit there and I would read the little prayer, you know, that he would have better things and bigger places to play and more people to come hear him.
How many times did you get hit with a nickel?
I got a nickel that right there. I think somebody threw a rock and got me right there.
It was a good luck anvil that this kid had. Toss his thing.
We knew when we looked out there that there wasn't going to be any room. So we just compensated by kicking it.
Fun little clubs. The audiences were really receptive.
That's a rock and roll crowd out there. They're mean.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, it's over. Done with the clubs.
I don't care. It was great. It was just nice being out there.
Very exciting to be able to play the big places. And once you start playing the big places on a regular basis, you have virtually no chance of being able to play these clubs again.
That's the whole thing of conquering the opening act syndrome. To be able to walk out there and kick ass with nothing.
After the gig.
This, we are doing this with a plan, you know, like a 3-year plan to open until we can't open anymore. And then at that point, we'll have to go out and headline. Getting big is the object, but doing it on our own terms.
Good, you know, so we didn't make our rent.
We're happening though. I think we're up to about $15 now.
Like those guys with the real
I don't know. I'll tell you what, you get your chops up playing out here like this. Actually, the conditions are better out here than in some major venues I've played in.
Busking is what they call that, where you go out and open up your case and just jam on the street like that. It was a lot of fun to just be out there with no sound check, no equipment, just a guitar and a saxophone. Surprised to see that my manager and my agent were down there trying to go through the nickels and dimes and quarters trying to commission it.
Come back no more. Come back no more.
All right.
All my life and long, I'm a
Reach the offices of mental management. You know the routine. Wait for the beep. Tommy, if it's you, I've got some good news. We've booked a couple of more weeks. We got 6 or 7 colleges in the Midwest and a barbecue joint in the South that's offering good money. Tommy, these guys want you bad. It's gonna help your career. Tommy, we're looking out for you, Tommy. Tommy, this is a big joint. Tommy, they got the best ribs in Memphis. Tommy, wait a second. Tommy! Cahill, he's leaving. Tommy!
Yeah, we do this a lot.
Oh, Peter.
Stay on the line.
Good boy, come on.
It's them again.
It's them hitting it off.
No, I'm getting tired of it's disguised.
But
no,
you guys leave me alone.
Anyone have a towel?
Can you write anything?
Yeah.
This is not easy out here, let me tell you. It's not as easy as it looks. Don't try this at home, kids.